This woman has just woken up from a 2-year coma. And this story isn't all that uncommon. People can be in comas for weeks, months, or years. And during that time, some of them might experience strange, lucid dreaming. But what else happens to your body when you're in a coma? On today's episode, we're going to find out. This is Your Body On a Coma. You can think of a coma as a very deep sleep, except you won't wake up to the sound of your alarm or your friend pranking you. But is it possible to have any sort of dreams during your comatose state? And how would your body and brain react to this traumatic experience? Let's find out. You could fall into a coma for many reasons. Physical injury, nervous system disease, or maybe a drug overdose. Or you could suffer from a medically induced coma. Doctors could put you in a coma on purpose to minimize brain activity, help you heal from intense pain, and to further prevent brain trauma. But regardless of how you got here, you're in a coma now. What's happening in and outside of your body? If you were in a coma, you would have zero awareness of the world around you. Things like touch, light, or sound would have no effect on you in this state. Your brain is still functioning, but at its most basic level. You may need a tube to help you swallow, but digesting your liquid food or staying hydrated shouldn't be a problem. Just don't expect any steak dinners. To the outside world, you wouldn't seem conscious. Your brainstem would have trouble communicating with your cerebrum, where cognitive consciousness happens. Your level of consciousness can vary, depending on the severity of your coma. If you're considered brain dead, you might be able to move your arms or wiggle your toes, but unfortunately, you would never recover. If you're catatonic, you'd be as stiff as a board. No movement or response of any kind. But in a vegetative state, you might grunt or yawn. You just wouldn't know what was going on around you. However, scientists believe that 15 to 20% of people in a vegetative state may be fully conscious. Also, research suggests that stimulating the senses may help a person recover. If you were in a non-induced coma, it's unlikely that you would be dreaming or even remember anything during your comatose state. This is because there's no evidence of changing brain activity. However, this may be different in a medically induced coma. You might remember things that never happened and have dreams or nightmares. These may be your brain's way of trying to make sense of outside stimuli it can't understand in its diminished state. Depending on the cause and the extent of damage, you could be in a coma from several days to several weeks. On rare occasions, some are in a coma for several years. If you were to remain in a coma for months or more, it's unlikely you'll ever wake up. But if you're lucky and you do happen to wake up, you might experience a dreamlike state as you slowly become aware of your surroundings. Now, after days, weeks, or months, you've finally woken up. If treated successfully, you might not have any permanent side effects. But if any brain damage has occurred, you may suffer from long-term impairment. The most likely issue you'll face will be the level of muscle atrophy. After all, you've been lying in a hospital with hardly any movement or activity. A coma can be a terrifying experience, but it doesn't mean that all hope is lost. Many people recover from comas and are able to recover their old lives. Now, this isn't the only trauma your body can experience. What would happen to your body if you suddenly stopped sweating? Well, we'll see what that effect has on us on another episode of Your Body On.